Arcade Game and Grognards. We're back today on Hedgerow Hell, which is our large-scale, hardcore US campaign in Gates of Hell Liberation. And it's day 20, Operation 20. We're moving slowly towards the end of what's a very big campaign. If we look at the map here, we can see that there's a lot of battles going on. I won't look at that for now, though. That looks like a tasty research map for us. Let's just go back. We've reconfigured the force. The 9 points that I had in research, I spent one of them on P-47 recon planes, because one of my subscribers, Juan, who always comments, he always watches my videos, he kind of said, you need to try using recon. So I'll try recon. Every time I've used recon in the past, it's got shot down, but we'll give recon a go. We're defending today, so we've got phase one, a little pocket, two glider platoons, engineers, mortar and browning, so we can establish an initial position against counterattacks. Then we're bringing in 2 3-inch anti-tank guns and the quad mount and another mortar to make a little mortar battery with the previous one, and some engineers to dig all that in. Then phase three, the support starts to arrive in the form of 2 more infantry squads, another quad mount to support these 275mm howitzers with ammunition and pull for that, and then a medic and bazooka. I think we've got a medic in. Is that our first medic on the board? Yeah, that's our first medic. Bit late for the first medic, but that's what we're doing. Second medic coming in phase four with more infantry, some anti-air, some aircraft support in a 3.7-meter flak, another howitzer, so 275s and 1.105, more gliders, snipers, flamers, bazookas, close support stuff in case we start to get overwhelmed. And then phase five, we're just bringing in 3 of these new 90mm GMC tanks. They cost us 8 research points to get to that point, but 90mm should deal with anything at all that the Germans throw at us. So that's our options. Let's take a look. We're going straight into Pont Hebert. Pont Hebert, it sounds like a bridge. And have we seen this before? Possibly. They're starting to get very familiar. Fortunately, it's not Rane and it's not Ancien, which are the two towns we fought over and over and over in this campaign. So it's a slightly different one. We are defending. We have got engineers. I am going to send the engineers into that town and block out the major roads with tank traps, force the enemy armor to come around the outside, hopefully into killing zones that we can set up with our anti-tank guns and finally the tanks. That's the rough plan. We've got 7 minutes, normally about seven and a half minutes after the start of the game to get our engineers digging us in and getting us settled. So we'll go take a look at this. And we're about to drop in. Let's drop in. There we go. We've got medium defenses, so we've got lots of support on our side. We'll let the sun come up just a little bit so we can see what's happening here. We've got 3 to defend. And we're down right there in the southwest, so let's come up. We're defending that one. That's pretty straightforward. That's a defense. We can leave that to the AI. That's more tricky. But I want to block out this road with engineers, with tank traps to stop that happening, and tank traps across here to stop movement there, and then way out there we've got the third one. I'm not going to defend that. That's too close. I'm going to focus on defending these two, and I'm going to assume that the enemy is going to come from the could come from the north or from the east. I don't know, but between here and here is tank traps. Tank traps here, I think tank traps across the corner of this building, and we're going to move forces forward. I think that's about it. I've got to improvise. Let's go. Let's jump into this one. So we have infantry. Okay, I'm going to send these infantry out to there on that side. Infantry up to here on that side. These are the engineers that we want. Tank traps there. A mortar team. Where's our objective? We'll get the mortar team into there.
We're ready.
Running, we haven't got big open fields of fire here, so we're gonna have to be careful. That road, that crossroads, could do with coverage from a mortar, from a Browning.
Ready to go.
And that's a second Browning. Might put those two Brownings together for now. Let's get one covering that road as well. We could come from, these guys could come from any direction. Right.
Waiting your command, sir.
Anti-tank guns, grab that one. We'll put an anti-tank gun there. Mortar's moving, grab that anti-tank gun.
Yes, sir.
Second set of engineers here. I really want these tank traps between the barrage. Stop them coming down that way.
Always ready.
Pick that up.
Ready to roll.
And that's a quad mount. Put the quad mount for there. This feels a little bit hairy.
Getting ready.
This does feel a little bit hairy. This feels like, okay. Mortar to there. Or do we put the other mortar there? We'll figure that out. We've got to call in three as well. So. Put an anti tank gun into there. Let's get a call in. Is it giving me all call ins in one swoop? Looks that way. So that's a 75 mil howitzer. We could do with a nice open field here. For the howitzers, one there.
What are your orders?
Yeah, another one there. Medics. Set up a medic station. Engineers are still moving into position. Anti-tank team. Get you into there, that building there. On ambush. We'll just put you into there as well, just in case something comes down that side.
Always ready.
Ready.
Browning, I'll put you there as well.
Ready, sir.
Infantry. We'll put you on reserve in this factory complex here.
We're ready.
Quad mount for there. You go there. Right, boys.
Awaiting orders, sir.
Move quick now.
Man, I'm getting real tired of these wet socks.
I want tank traps there.
Aye, sir.
I want tank traps there. Everybody moving?
Aye.
No, we've still got a Browning out there. This could be very hairy. Very hairy indeed. Don't just stand around, boys. Don't know where they're coming from. Let's just dig you in. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay. You boys. There's a road here. Can you get nice? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Whoever's got the mines, go do that. Good boys. Anyone else got mines? How are we doing on tank traps? They're done.
Ready to go, sir.
Yeah, let's have some more here. How are you doing? You're done good.
Order,
yeah, I want tank traps there. Have you mined up that road so quick? You have. Well done, guys. 1, 2, 3, 4, get dug into there. You've got mines as well. Perfect. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Get those in there. You're mining away. That's good.
Ready, sir.
Ready to go.
I want both howitzers there. Where's the 105?
Yep.
Face that way. Mortars.
Ready to go, sir. Consider it done, sir.
Ready.
That gun into there.
Awaiting orders.
And that's another 3-inch gun. Just put that to there.
Yep. Ready to roll.
New mortar go to there. Yeah, you're trapping up there. You're trapping up there. Then we need something down here. Because we haven't got a direction yet.
I'm ready. Any orders, sir? Ready to go, sir.
Yeah, you boys, you got mines as well. Wow, you are stars. In which case, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And you guys, you've got 11 mines. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Get those mined up. Okay, they're coming from this direction. Okay, you're done.
Yes.
You're done. You're going to come back here. And you can put some more tank traps for me there. And they're coming in from that side. So our anti-tank guns are in the wrong direction.
Yes, sir.
That's a flat gun. It's a bit of a mess. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. We've got a Browning there, but we really need an anti-tank gun.
Always ready.
Okay, we're getting a strong push in that direction. Anti-tank gun there. Quad mount there. Okay, we lost both of those guys. So we need an anti-tank gun on this corner.
What's your order, sir?
Hurry up with those rounds.
Right there. Right, that's a heavy howitzer. Where's our howitzer field? That's going to go there. Gun just around there somewhere. You're getting that hedgerow. It's a Neverwerfer. Can you go and just shoot that? Get them? Grab that Neverwerfer, man. Get that out of there, that's ours. Right, we need to be moving fast over here. More in. Nebble now. Bring that back here. Flamethrowers. Infantry squad into that gap there. Into reserve here. Some artillery on that. Where's our other anti-tank gun? This is all over the place. That's an anti-tank gun. That one's looking down the street. Move that a bit further down the street. Ten, get some more mines down in that area. Right, you reserve boys, you're gonna have to occupy that courtyard. Okay, we've got a phase five. Anti-tank team to here.
What are your orders?
Crew. Okay, we've got a tank battle going to go on here. We've got another Browning there. I want a Browning on this side. Burn him. Okay, that's doing. Where's our tank platoon? Oh, this is a bit hot. Yeah. get those 90 mils on it. Get that. Repaired. What happened to our anti-tank team? These boys. Get around the side of him. Wow, this is a furious fight. Our tank, that looked like our tank. Nice job, boys. To that corner. Get into that corner. Right, we need medics and snipers. Okay, we're going to continue. We are going to continue. We do need medics. And I can't remember what we do to them. Going quiet.
We got enemy tanks here.
What I'd give to see the American sky.
Do we get the smoke down? Chaotic battle.
Keep going, boys.
Get him up. Get him up. Nice. What have we got back here? Crew. They're going to be useful. We'll get some crew over here. And medics, we're going to need you. Okay, and a couple more snipers. You can be useful around here. Let's just finish this battle off now. Get that tank repaired. Come on, man. Come on, medics. Do your job. Come on, he's bleeding. What's the matter with you?
There.
Wow. Wow.
We've got enemy tanks here.
Get that medic back to there.
Identify target.
Okay, you're cool. Is that an aircraft? That's an aircraft. Where is our flak gun? got him. Come on, flanker. You see that plane? There he goes. Is he going to turn and come back? He's coming back.
Give him some rounds.
Tanks incoming.
Come on, flat gun. Don't let him bomb us. Pilot burning. Wow. Okay. Well. Yeah, I'm not sure you need a medic right now. You guys can heal up. Well, that was pretty brutal. That was pretty brutal. Pretty brutal. Flat guns didn't do a job. Okay, it looks like we've gone quiet. We're there. We're going to recover the battlefield, and I'll be back in just a moment. Okay, Gronyars, well, we're back on the battlefield, and that was an incredibly chaotic battle. I mean, really, really totally chaotic. I kind of kept some kind of grip on what was going on there, but and we did get that plane down eventually, but not until after it dropped its payload into the town, but it was all a bit late. What was chaotic? Well, we kind of got the direction right. We sort of got it right. This little outpost in the farmstead here, and the mine laying down this road, look at all these mine detonations, did some kind of good for us. Then they kept pushing through here, but we get control of this. The quad mount did a great job there in taking out soft skin vehicles and infantry. In fact, both the quad mounts, I couldn't see what they were doing. I could hear what they're doing. Grabbing that Nebel towards the start of the game was great, but I have no idea what happened to it. It's not appeared in my inventory. Don't know where it is. Don't know what happened. I have to go back and look at the kill feed. But that was a pretty solid defense. And again, you know, if you ever needed convincing, using tank traps on these French villages and force your opponent's tanks to make their way through the bocage, where you can pick them off with nicely placed anti-tank guns like this one. Again, from my perspective, that was completely chaotic game. The AI, my soldier's AI, was working full speed. What is that? What is that thing? That's a Wesper. It's a big artillery piece. It's not giving me a name on that one. I was just lucky that the AI held it together. I mean, I got some stuff into position. I think this field with this anti-tank gun covering this with the Brownings meant no progress could be made. The tanks came around here where they fell prey to this little anti-tank team. But lots of cool stuff in the battle, but I really need to go back, look at that again, and try and understand what the hell was going on. That's the kind of summary of defensive games in Liberation. They are really hard because you just simply don't know which way the enemy is going to come at you. Okay, let's get out of here. Let's take a finish. We've won. Defense, 30% casualties, that's about acceptable. We expect 50% casualties on the offense, around 30% on the defense. A lot of vehicle kills in there. Let's take one last look and then get back to the operations screen. Okay, we're done. And 8.8 research points, cash and stars. Cash and ammunition, but not stars. That's okay. And our force is largely intact. We lost one of the 90mm tanks towards the end there. It got a bit shot up, but we can't complain that we've lost two battles, 118 in the series. We're back on the offensive next time in Hedgerow Hell, but we'll leave it for there for now. It's quite a long video. So once again, thank you so much for watching. It's so appreciated. I mean, really, really, particularly if you watch this to the end, I will see you guys soon, and I certainly hope I'll see you on the next battle in Hedgerow Hell, or indeed Atlantic Wall or Close Combat, the three campaigns that I've currently got running. But until then, from Gaming Gronyards, once more from me to you, it is bye for now.
Over there, send the word, over there, that the Yanks are coming.
It's gaming graveyards.